Hello friends, in the last video on process capability, we had seen all concepts used in process capability analysis and their meaning with the help of self-explaining graphs for easy understanding and better clarity. We are going to learn first type of capability analysis, that is normal capability analysis, with practical example in this video. So let's begin. Normal capability analysis. Normal capability analysis is used to evaluate the potential, that is within, and overall capability of your process based on a normal distribution. Using this analysis, you can determine whether the process is capable of producing output that meets customer requirements and compare the overall capability of the process with its potential, that is within capability, to assess opportunity for improvement. To perform this analysis, you must specify a lower or upper specification limit or both to define your process requirements. Data considerations for normal capability analysis. To ensure that your results are valid, consider the following guidelines when you collect the data, perform the analysis, and interpret your results. 1. The data should be continuous. Continuous data are measurements that may potentially take on any numerical value within a range of values along a continuous scale, including fractional or decimal values. Common examples include measurements such as length, weight, and temperature. If you have attribute data such as count of defectives or defects, use binomial capability analysis or Poisson capability analysis. We will see these types of analysis in future videos. 2. The data should follow a normal distribution. The process capability estimates for this analysis are based on the normal distribution. If the data are not normally distributed, the capability estimates will not be accurate for your process. If your data is non-normal, you can transform them using the boxcar transformation or the Johnson transformation, which are included in the transform option of this analysis. To determine whether your data are normal or whether a transformation will be effective for non-normal data, use individual distribution identification. If your data are non-normal and the transformation is not effective, consider using non-normal capability analysis. 3. The process must be stable and in control. If the current process is not stable, then the capability indices cannot be reliably used to assess the future and ongoing capability of the process. If you are not sure whether your process is in control, use X-bar H chart to evaluate the process stability before you perform this analysis. 4. Collect enough data to obtain reliable estimate of process capability. Try to collect at least 100 total data points, that is subgroup size into number of subgroups, such as 25 subgroups of size 4 or 35 subgroups of size 3. If you do not collect a sufficient amount of data over a long enough period of time, the data may not accurately represent different sources of process variation, and the estimate may not indicate the true capability of your process. 5. Data should be collected in a rational subgroup if possible. A rational subgroup is a small sample of similar atoms that are produced over a short period of time and that are representative of the process. Observations for each subgroup should be collected under the same inputs and conditions, such as personnel, environment, or equipment. If you do not collect rational subgroups, the variation in the subgroups may reflect special causes rather than natural, inherent variation of the process. Example of normal capability analysis. A manufacturer of cable wire wants to assess if the diameter of the cable meets specifications. A cable wire must be 0.55 plus or minus 0.05 cm in diameter to meet engineering specifications. Analysts evaluate the capability of the process to ensure it is meeting the customer requirement of a PPQ of 1.33. Every hour, analysts take a subgroup of 5 consecutive cable wires from the production line and record the diameter in worksheet. Before performing normal capability analysis, analysts confirm whether it is following a normal distribution by conducting normality test. To conduct normality test, select Stat, Basic Statistics, and then Normality Test. In variable, select diameter. The test results indicate whether you should reject or fail to reject the null hypothesis that the data came from a normally distributed population. From this graph, we can see the p-value for the Anderson-Darling normality test of the cable diameter data is 0.794. This value is greater than the chosen alpha level of 0.05, indicating that the data follows a normal distribution. To perform normal capability analysis to evaluate the diameter of the cables in relation to the specification limits, please follow these steps. 1. Select Stat, Quality Tools, Capability Analysis, and then Normal. 2. In single column, enter diameter. 3. In subgroup size, enter 5. 4. In lower specification, enter 0.50. 5. In upper specification, enter 0.60. 6. Click Options. 7. In target, add CPM to table, enter 0.55 and add title for the graph. And 8. Click OK in each dialog box to get the results. We will get the results of study in graph window. Interpretation of results. Your data appears to have been followed a normal distribution as shown by the histogram overlaid with a normal curve. But you can see that the process mean of 0.54646 is slightly short of the target of 0.55, and both the tails of the distribution fall outside the specification limits. This means you will sometimes see the cable diameters less than lower specification of 0.50 cm or greater than the upper specification of 0.60 cm. The PPK index indicates whether the process will produce units within the tolerance limits. Here, the PPK index is 0.80, indicating that the manufacturer must improve the process by reducing variability and centering the process on target. Apparently, the large variation in the process is a much more severe problem for this production line compared to the process not being centered on target. Likewise, the PPM total, that is, expected overall performance, is the number of parts per million, that is 10969.28, whose characteristics of interest is out of the tolerance limits. This means that approximately 10969 out of 1 million cables do not meet the specifications. The manufacturer is not meeting customer requirements and should improve its process by reducing the process variation. This is all about normal process capability. We will see between and within capability analysis with practical examples in the next video. Apart from this video, on your request, I have uploaded my first course content on Udemy in the form of notes in Microsoft Word as well as videos. If you want to download it, you can click on the link provided in the description and use this code to get lifetime access with the limited offer of 39% discount. For references, I have taken some part of this very detailed content from Minitab. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful, add your valuable comments, and share this video to your friends and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such a videos from my channel, please do not forget to subscribe it and click on the bell icon and select to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.